Hi guys, and today we talk about 10 things that are different in German versus American homes. Number one, the doorknob. In Germany, we don't have doorknobs, we have rather handles. Throughout the house, you will have on every door, door handles, not doorknobs. And there's a really huge selection on door handles. Silver, gold, different shapes, there is a huge selection and usually they tend to look really modern. Number two, usually American homes and even apartments don't have a real hallway right at the entrance, which is a very common thing in Germany. It doesn't matter if you are living in an apartment or a house, you will have a hallway that is usually to store your shoes or your coats and jackets. And so there is the space that most of us here in the US don't have. Some houses have a mud room, so it is a little bit like a mud room. So I think it might be because of the weather in Germany, we can get really cold winters. So of course you need more jackets and shoes and all these things. So I could imagine that where it's colder in the US, in the northern states, that you can find more mud rooms as well. But that is in Germany a completely normal thing. Everybody has a hallway, a flur, how we call it, to store their things. Another reason, probably in the US, why we don't really have that is that Germans always take their shoes off before they go inside. And so they have the opportunity to do this in their hallway. While many people in the US don't take their shoes off. Let me know how you handle that in your house. Do you take your shoes off or do you often go inside with your shoes? Number three, the light switches look completely different in Germany. And there's a huge selection in Germany actually of different kinds of light switches. And they look pretty modern. You can have them in every color you desire. And they're usually this big square. While we have here, most of the times, this really standard American light switch. Most homes have that. Most of my friends have these. And they look kinda outdated when you compare them to the German light switch. Of course, also the power outlet looks different in Germany. Germans always say the American outlet looks kinda like a surprised face. So yeah, we have only two holes in our power outlet instead of three. And the plug itself seems for me more stable. Like the American plugs, some of them can bend. Like from my Shark steamer, I was pulling a little too strong on the outlet and now one of these little plugs is a little bent, which that has never happened to me with a German plug. I feel like they are higher quality and they don't bend as easy. Number four, garbage disposal. In most countries in the EU, garbage disposals are banned. Garbage disposals are highly controversial in most EU countries. They don't think this is good for the environment, and I don't see anytime soon that they will allow the use of garbage disposals, which is a very common thing in the US to have. Number five, the windows in Germany are so different. For me, American windows feel kinda flimsy. The whole quality is not that good. We Germans love our German windows and they are really high quality. At least if you have windows starting from the 80s, they're really thick glass, really good glass, and they have this amazing technology that is always surprising for Americans to see if they have never seen it. Not only can we completely open the window, which in the US is not really possible, you can only kind of push it up a little bit but never completely open it. So you can open it like a door, or if you choose, you can tilt it. And I mean, I miss that, and it's just an amazing window. And these videos here are from my friend in Germany. And Germans also, what they like to do is Stoßlüften. And that means you tilt your windows in multiple rooms of your house or your apartment to get the wind flowing through so that you really get some good fresh air from outside. Then number six, the toilet. In Germany, we have usually a hanging toilet. So the toilet isn't connected directly to the floor. And I tell you, this is amazing if you mop the floors. You can so easily reach everything. So those hanging toilets are amazing, and we should do that here in the US too. Number seven, before moving to the US, I have never seen a shower where you have a shower head literally only coming out the wall, meaning there is no handheld shower head. I was so surprised by that. And in Germany, I have never seen anything like that. People all have a handheld shower head. They are available here. Super cheap too, you can get them everywhere, at Walmart, Home Depot, Lowe's, everywhere. And still, many people have just a showerhead that comes out the wall and don't have the handheld showerhead. Number eight, most Germans do not have an AC. And now that all over the world temperatures are rising, they really start to feel the need of having an AC during summer. When I grew up in Germany when I was young, there was not really a need for it. It wasn't as hot as it gets today. So what we have is usually a radiator, some kind of a radiator to heat during the winter, but there is nothing to cool in the summer. And now some Germans have started to install ACs, but it's still a minority. Most Germans won't have an AC in their house. Number nine, most Germans won't have a dryer, and that is probably because electricity is really expensive in Germany. It costs much more than here in the US, and so people don't have a dryer. Usually they will have a drying rack. It's really funny for me that I'm used now to the US and I never see people having a drying rack in the middle of their living room or something. And that can really happen in Germany, that you visit a friend and he just has a drying rack full of clothes in the middle of his living room. This is just pretty normal and standard to do that in Germany. There will be a handful of people who do own a dryer, but most Germans won't have a dryer. And number 10, in Germany, I spoke about this in my last video, we do not have any kind of closets. Instead, we have furniture to store all our things, furniture and shelves. I just love how amazing that is in American homes, that you have all these closets to store all your things. This is amazing and keeps the house neat and clean. And this is something that I really enjoy and would miss a lot in Germany. And there you go. Those were 10 things that are different in American and German homes. I hope you enjoyed this video. Stay healthy, everybody. See you in my next video. Bye bye.